Okay. Naka-play na ba?
Mm-hmm.
Ay. Teka lang. Play. Hello everyone and welcome to our episode for this week. And yes, simple lang yung pag-uusapan natin ngayon, no?
Oh.
Where to invest in 2019.
Siyempre, okay. 2019 na. Yun yung pag-uusapan natin.
So, si Rienzie, ikaw daw ay nag-research?
Nag-interview, yeah. I've done some research. Research, tapos may mga nakausap din ako mga experts, mga investment experts, no?
Mm-hmm.
In their own fields. And they give their views on ano ba yung mga pwede natin i-consider to invest in 2019.
Mm-hmm. So, investment outlook for this year.
Kumbaga, given all of these events that are happening, no? So, like for example, for 2019, kasi well, generally speaking, they see yung isa sa mga major theme talaga is yung US-China trade war.
That will continue to affect
the
global economy and the markets.
Of course, US market is strengthening, si China nag-slow down, but whatever effect that these two countries would have regarding their agreement would really affect everything, especially sa world market. So having said that, medyo kailangan talaga nating tingnan kung anong mangyayari at magbasa-basa tayo ng balita regarding that one. But on the local front, they see generally na malakas pa rin ang Philippine market.
Okay.
GDP would hit around 6 to 6.5% for the year. So okay pa rin siya, it's still strong. And isa rin sa mga drivers ng economy for this year would be the Build project ng government, of course.
Parang nagsimula na siya dati, di ba?
But
so what's different this year?
Well, they see more implementation this year.
More implementation
okay. This year, that's one. Yung train 2, parang medyo, they're different drafts eh. So kumbaga hindi pa alam kung ano yung draft na mapapasa. So medyo on hold pa yung train 2, okay? And then, so isa din sa mga driver for this year is the inflation rate natin and then the inflation outlook. Of course, syempre pag sa inflation is, it determines largely, no, kung magtataas ng interest rate sa central bank or hindi. Okay, so this overseas and local developments would really largely influence this year. So having said that, saan ba pwede mag-invest? Okay, iba-iba yan.
Okay,
for example, pag pinag-usapan natin ng fixed income market or yung mga bonds, so you can consider, since generally interest rate environment sa buong mundo is paakyat, okay, they call it tightening, so you might wanna consider bonds na medyo short duration or yung tipong
short term
mga less than 5 years.
Yes.
Less than 5 years. So with that, you look for money market funds, okay siya. Yung mga bonds na medyo long term, medyo iwas muna, hindi muna for the year. Although ang outlook nila, since ang inflation for the year is medyo magta-taper na, kasi last year mga nag 6.5 tayo, 6.7 at the highest.
Okay. 6.7.
For this year, nakikita nila mga 4.5 lang.
So
medyo bababa siya.
Uh-oh.
So it would give less pressure for the BSP to hike up interest rate.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
So with that, medyo but again, no, medyo long term bonds, medyo ano muna, iwas muna ng konti. They can do some cherry picking, choose some opportunities, 10-25 year, pero if you're a newbie investor, medyo iwas ka muna ng mga long term bonds. Not unless na medyo mag-stabilize completely yung interest rate level sa market. US, hindi nila nakikita na mag-aakit ang interest rate for the year, okay? Or kung mag-aakit man, medyo low probability event for them. Okay? So, pagdating sa bonds yun, pagdating sa equities market, ito, ang mga pwede na lang tingnan. Yan. Dahil build. So, ano ba yung mga mag-aaral? Pakikinabang sa build. So, banks, they can look for banks, number one. They can look for conglomerates.
Meaning,
kunwari, isa sa mga conglomerates is Ayala. Ayala Corp, San Miguel. Ito yung mga companies na may mga smaller companies na masali. Yan. Okay. Most especially, yung mga may exposure sa build.
Okay.
Like, for example, yung Bulacan Airport, San Miguel yun.
That's right.
So, not necessarily San Miguel yung nagbebenta ng beer, but San Miguel Corp, okay, which is
the holdings company.
The holdings company, yun. Yes. Consider nila yun. Another one would be property.
Mm-hmm.
Maganda rin ang property. Kasi right now, BPO And yung mga tinatawag na Philippine offshore game, yung mga offshore gaming operators, okay, mga Pogo na tinatawag, nagda-drive up siya ng office space.
That's right.
Oo. And then, spillover niya yung residential segment. Mm. Okay. So, BPO and Pogo, nagda-drive up ng demand for office space and demand for
and
condo.
Residential.
And residential. So, in effect, real estate would be good. Property companies.
Property companies.
For 2019.
Those are conglomerates.
Okay. Next is mga industrial. Tinanan lang na sa Bloomberg yan, mga industrial and selected consumer stocks because of, nakalimutan ko, 2019 is election year.
Yes. Oh.
So, midterm election. So, yung mga...
Parang US, a midterm election talaga.
So, yung mga selected consumer stocks.
Like?
Like, ayoko sabihin.
Ah, sige.
Basta selected, email nyo na lang kami for more detailed information.
Basta, kasi ano siya, no? Pag election, may ano, may drive when it comes to printing
and, yeah. pakain
no? Kasi may mga campaign period, yung mga victory parties and all. Although it's just on the first half of the year, but it really...
Malaking effect niya.
Maraming budget kasi yung lalabas, no?
So, and advertising even.
And advertising. So, would you say that media stocks would do
media
well?
Media would do well for the year, I would think. Although, as with all investments din kasi, parang bumibili ka lang ng lupa, tingnan mo rin yung price kung mura siya. So always check the value of the stocks na binibili niyo kung mura siya. Ganun lang naman yun. Basta ako ang tingin ko sa stocks is if you buy it, okay, para siyang lupa, tingnan mo kung mura siya. Ayun, relative to its historical value and relative also to the value ng
book
mga
value niya, di ba?
Or book value among others and value ng mga peers niya rin.
Okay. Yun.
Kasi so, baka mamaya mahal pa siya versus kunwari Bucks, di ba? Medyo mahal. Tapos mura, dito tayo sa mura.
That's right.
Tinantin nila yung ano, yung mga stocks na nagbibigay ng magandang dividends.
Dividends.
For the year and yung mga may healthy cash flow.
Mm.
Yun. So, always do your due diligence.
Ano
so,
pang
stock
ano?
Market. Currencies.
Currencies, okay. What's your currency outlook? Dyan.
Currency outlook, of course, trade war din. Pero yung mga tied sa commodities, basically, no, okay of our friend Mark. So GBP would be okay, Euro, Australian dollar, New Zealand dollar, and Canadian.
Ay, mga commodity dollars, comdals.
Comdals, parang pusikat dolls lang.
Yeah, mga comdals ang tawag ko dyan, commodity dollars. Aussie, Kiwi, tsaka CAD.
Yun, so watch out for those ano, for those currencies as well for 2019.
What do you mean watch out?
Watch out or pwede kayong mag-play sa currencies na yun.
They will tend to be volatile.
Volatile, pero
so may mga,
mag-appreciate yan.
Mag-appreciate yung mga comdals. Okay. So, sa mga interested sa forex trading, no? You can contact me. Meron akong alam. And we discussed a little bit about forex trading.
Oh yeah,
in one of our videos.
Video
so you can look for that.
Sa playlist natin.
Okay, so ano pa ang outlook mo?
Ano pa ba? So basically, 2019 would be not as, should we say, not as spectacular because of this ongoing trade war, ganyan, geopolitical concerns. But nonetheless, there's nothing to fear for 2019.
Yun yung mas important.
Nothing to fear. There's still no recession in sight na nakikita. And Philippine economy is still stable, fundamentals are okay, GDP is growing pa din. Okay, so twin drivers ng economy natin, BPO and OFW, still stable.
Mm-hmm.
So nothing to worry mo, especially if you're a long-term investor. Okay, so invest lang kayo.
Oo, actually, especially if you're a long-term investor, you don't really have to time kung kailan ka mag-invest.
Yes.
The best time to invest is really today, now, yeah. No? And the only reason why you should not invest is if there's any big negative economic news, di ba?
Kasi, totoo.
And as per your research, chill lang tayo this year. Which means, those who have been investing for the past should just continue.
Yes.
Tapos yung mga hindi pa nagsa-start mag-invest, magsimula na sila ngayon, di ba?
Basta ang ano natin diyan, ang rule natin diyan, if you need the money more than 5 years, you can consider the stock market. or any equity fund, okay? But if you need the money within 5 years or less, dito nung
kasi iwas sila sa mga stocks.
Iwas na kasi medyo
sinasabi sila sa mga low, tsaka low to moderate type of investment.
Like bonds.
Yeah. Which they can always ask us, no? You can email us at admin@wealtharchy.com if you have questions. And of course, if you want to be your partner sa inyong partner sa kanilang wealth building, then you can definitely have us as your financial planner.
Yeah, objective and unbiased advice.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll scout the market for the best product for you.
Oo. So customize sa kanilang financial goals yung kanilang investment plan. Okay? Kasi hindi namin kayo bibentahan ng kung ano-anong produkto.
Hindi.
We will really give them a financial strategy on how to reach the goals that they have.
And sometimes I do advice against investing din.
Kasi pag nakita mong may ibang mas urgent na priority when it comes to their personal finance, di ba?
Yeah. So email us.
Okay? So email us at admin@wealtharchy.com. And if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our channel. At kung gusto niyo ng notification pag meron kaming bagong video, i-click niyo yung bell para meron kayong instant notification. Okay?
So that's it.
That's it. Bye-bye and see you next week. Bye-bye.
See you next week. Bye-bye.